And I just want to point this out before I biff it, because I have before. No party preference with a ton of endorsements from all sorts of people all over the place. Gayle McLaughlin, thank you for joining us.
Oh, thank you, John. It's a pleasure to be here, as it was a couple times in the past.
Yeah, you've been here a lot. Thank you for joining us. Like having
you.
Sure,
yeah.
It's nice. So, and thank you for joining us on this not really a holiday for either one of us. We kind of talked about that. You're campaigning, which is what you just kind of have to do 24/7, right?
Absolutely, yeah. That's what it takes.
It does. So, I know you've got a lot of reasons for running, but just kind of give everybody the overall what you're running for here.
Sure. Yes. Yeah. So I'm running as the only corporate-free candidate for California Lieutenant Governor, as I ran my previous four campaigns in Richmond, California, where I served as mayor for 2 years. I ran all four of my campaigns, two for mayor and two for council member, without any corporate money, and won in spite of Chevron's millions trying to defeat me and other progressives. And I'm the only candidate for lieutenant governor that has any experience governing a city. And, you know, as mayor, I was really honored to lead a remarkable transformation in Richmond, where we were able to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour and route to even more, a larger hourly wage, a living wage, where we passed rent control, we were the only, this was the only new rent control law in 30 years in California. Yeah. We also reduced crime dramatically, a 75% reduction in homicides. We got over $100 million in additional taxes from Chevron, huge, the big oil refinery in our city, and we limited their pollution. And we also did things like join a community choice energy program where we have cleaner and greener and cheaper energy. And we did this, I want to mention this, by building a progressive alliance, the Richmond Progressive Alliance, of which I was a co-founder. And the purpose of the RPA, the Richmond Progressive Alliance, is to run candidates without corporate money and build a local movement for local political power. We did that. We're encouraging that up and down California. New progressive alliances have emerged. And when elected lieutenant governor, I will facilitate a network of these progressive alliances and also the local Our Revolution chapters and the statewide unions. And we'll have that statewide power to address and pressure the legislature to pass single-payer Medicare for all, free public college, progressive millionaires tax, reforming Prop 13 by closing the corporate loophole, banning fracking, a public bank, so many other issues. And people agree with these issues. Yeah. That's why, as you mentioned, John, so many wonderful groups have endorsed me. We have the endorsement of the Bernie Sanders, Our Revolution, the national organization, and 35 local California chapters of Our Revolution. We also were endorsed by the Peace and Freedom Party, by 10 Democratic Socialists of America groups, many Green Party groups, by the Movement for a People's Party, yeah. So many other groups. And, you know, people get it that we have to come together and build a big progressive tent. So, and really make it clear that, you know, we need to be a force against the corporations who have really dominated our lives and our political process. So that's why I'm running, and I'm really proud to be a part of this.
That's awesome. You covered. I never need to really ask you more than one question, Gayle. You just, it's all right there. And just, I want to recap for everybody that doesn't know what Gayle was trying to talk about really fast was the fact that she basically worked a progressive movement, took over a town, became mayor, and brought Chevron to heel along with a whole bunch of other corporations. Okay.
Wow, Jen. Okay. That says it well, but I did it as a part of a movement.
Yes, you led the way. Let me rephrase. It took a lot of people power to do that, and you're still leading the way. You're not lieutenant governor yet, but right now you're already organizing, and you've got a ton of progressive groups that have come around you. Like you said, you're endorsed by so many different groups. I don't know of any candidate that is endorsed by this many groups. You really are showing that it's about the issues, and it's just huge what you've accomplished in California. So thank you.
Well, thank you, John. I mean, it's good groups and social media shows like this that really help spread the word.
Aw, thank you so much. And that means you guys out there have to do your part. Hashtag no more fools, right? And we need to support Gayle because what she's doing is insane. And I mean that in a nice way. She's just, she is bringing California together in the progressive movement and it just under one giant happy roof. And it really needs to happen. And so nmf.uphillmedia.org. Or Gayle, tell us where you're going to, I mean, you're all over the place, but tell everybody where you're going to be next.
Well, actually, there's some big things coming up. My book it actually is released already. We're going to be getting copies of them. I wrote a book on the years that I served in Richmond. It's called Winning Richmond, How a Progressive Alliance Won City Hall.
Nice.
And we're having the book launch on April 15th in Richmond. We also are going to, Nina Turner is coming to California.
Sweet.
She's coming to LA to do an event for my campaign. And then
really?
On April 27th, and she's coming to the Bay Area, to Berkeley on April 28th to support me and two other progressives. So, you know, if people sign up on my website, if they go to gayleforcalifornia.org, they can get details about these events. So we will be sharing them through our email and putting them on our website. And we definitely want people to come to these events, you know, learn about my book and hear from Nina and
yeah.
hear how our campaigns are really the ones that are corporate free and need to be supported.
That's awesome. I really appreciate you saying that. I love the Gayle Force. That's awesome.
Yeah.
I
like We've that. Got a whole bunch of corporate free candidates that I'm supporting. So, yeah, and you know, the fool issue that you raised, if I could just speak
yeah,
to that
yeah.
briefly, you know, it's like I mentioned, I'm the only corporate free candidate running for lieutenant governor, and the other candidates are supported by big corporations and big super PACs, and I think that's foolish. You know, a fool is someone lacking wisdom and common sense, and these candidates don't have common sense for the people. They seem to have, you know, it's not that they're not smart people, but they're using their intelligence for privilege and to support and stand for the greedy corporations and developers. So what my campaign is doing is doing a different kind of approach. You know, the Grateful Dead has a line in one of their songs that say, don't lend your hand to raise no flag, atop no ship of fools. Well, my campaign and the progressive movement is sailing a different ship. You know, we're putting people first. And, you know, we have the people's wisdom. We're no fools. We're using the people's wisdom to build the kind of California that where everyone can thrive.
That's awesome. I love how you tie that in there. We even have that song on our list. You're so awesome.
Oh, good.
Yeah. And I just want to show everybody, this is some of the candidates running in this race, and just some. And Gayle's right. It's not that any of them are fools in terms of intelligence, but they certainly are taking money from corporate interests. And that is something that Gayle and the Progressive Alliance of just can't. I mean, I didn't even add that, like, you're not just building progressive folks, you're endorsing, supporting, and helping to run progressive candidates in California. And that's
right.
just
that's
huge.
Right. That's what it takes. We all have to come together. We really do. This big progressive tent of progressive candidates, corporate-free progressive candidates, progressive organizations, progressive elected officials that are already in office that are corporate-free. We've got what it takes. We just have to unify and show the kind of force that we have.
Awesome. Gayle McLaughlin, thank you so much for running. It is the hardest thing to do in this revolution.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you for joining us on No More Fools. We're done. That's it. You like nailed it out of the park.
Well, thank you, Chad. I enjoy, as always, being on your show.